Okay, so this shortcut right here is going to be the kind of little pinhole where if we can just wriggle our way through, we're going to find there's a whole world out there of thinking about energy in a different way. So I'm going to use the work done by gravity as kind of a means to an end to find out how we could really further develop the ideas that we've gotten to so far, the ideas that are in the work method. Let me go ahead and suppose a couple scenarios. Let me go over here. So I'm going to develop a work done by gravity shortcut. It's going to be a big shortcut. You'll be surprised at how easy it is to compute the work done by gravity in any situation. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to mark off two heights. I'm going to call the difference between them delta h. So that's the height difference between them. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a look at several different ways that I could get between these two heights. The first most obvious is dropping something. Then it'll just proceed in a straight line, going faster and faster, of course, but along a straight line between the two heights. I'll call that path A. Path B, it's going to proceed in a straight line but diagonally. And then path C, I'm going to throw something horizontally, and it's going to proceed in one of these arc-shaped patterns that we know so well. And that'll be path C. Now, for full disclosure, only paths A and C could happen under gravity only. Those are A and C, gravity can be the only force that's active. B, it can't. There's no way something would move diagonally down in a straight line under gravity only. You would need another force. Like, for instance, if I took this eraser, I could carry it down to the diagonal, but in addition to the force of gravity, there's a force from my hand, right? That's not really relevant because in each case, I want to compute the work done by gravity only, and whether or not there are other works is kind of irrelevant. So in all three of these situations, I want to compute what's the work done by gravity. So let's go ahead, and each of these cases, the force of gravity is unwaveringly downward. That's the beauty, is that no matter what you do, gravity pulls down. The difference, of course, is the displacement. The displacement looks very different. The displacement on this one looks like this. Let's start with that one. So let's start with path A. Work done by gravity is size of the force. Well, that's mg. Size of displacement. Well, that's just delta H. And let me put in an absolute value sign simply because deltas can generally be negative, and so I just want to be absolutely sure here because I'm going to a lower height. I don't want an extra negative sneaking up on me there. And then cosine of, what's the angle between the force and displacement?
Zero.
They're exactly pointed the same way. This is plus one, so I get my work done by gravity. Looks like this. It's positive. Positive meaning, of course, that it increases the kinetic energy. And hopefully that's not terribly shocking, right? When something, you drop it, it goes faster because gravity increases the kinetic energy of it. That's going to be kind of my baseline to compare the other ones to. So let me move on to path B. In path B, of course, my displacement looks like this. So let me put in the work done by gravity size of the force, size of the displacement, times cosine of, and here, it's not zero anymore, right? Whatever this angle is, I need that angle. So I'll just leave it as cosine of theta. Now, you might think that's the end of the road, because I don't know the displacement. The only thing I know is it's larger than delta h, right? And I don't know the theta. However, I know their combination. I know what they are together. And here's the reason why. If you make a sketch of this triangle that this thing went on, delta x is the hypotenuse. Delta x cosine theta is this side, which is what?
Delta
h. And look at that. I got the same exact thing as I did before. It's the same as I got previously. How did that happen? Well, let's take a look at how that is possible and thinking conceptually. Path B is a diagonal straight line, and we can take that and think of it as a downward motion and a sideways motion together. So the first part, when you go down, well, that's of course identical to trip A, right? And why didn't the fact that we went to this side mean more work? Well, of course, when you're moving to the side, when your displacement on your second part is to the side, you're moving 90 degrees to the force, so no more work can be added. Gravity could care less about that sideways part. It only cares about the vertical part. When you are moving vertically, gravity is either helping you in this case or possibly hurting you. It doesn't care about the sideways part at all. And so A and B, they both have the same vertical motion, so they have the same work done. Well, let's take a look at path C. Path C, or any path, can be thought of as sideways parts and vertical parts. The work done on path C is the same thing. The work done by gravity depends only on the height change. That's a major revelation. That's what we have to think for gravity always pulling vertically no matter what you do. If you move vertically, it can do work, but if there's any sideways part, who cares? So if I give you path D, where the motion was like this, okay, before we would have no chance of computing anything about that. Here, who cares about those details? You just look at the height change, and that's all you need. So all of these things go through the same height change. All of them have the same exact work. In fact, just to finish up the thought, if you were to allow delta H to be negative, then this would be appropriate for the entire formula. If delta H was positive, which you went to a larger height, then of course gravity acts against you. That's what the extra minus sign ends up being necessary. If delta H is negative because you go to a lower height, then of course gravity helps you. But the only thing you need to know about the work done by gravity is your height change. Nothing else matters. And this is going to allow us to compute some crazy trajectories because we don't care about most of the details of them. Okay, so I'll pick this thread up on Friday.